What's going on, everybody, and welcome back to SoCal Exploring. My name is Scott, and you're watching your stop for all things theme park and attraction related. If you guys are new here, make sure you're subscribed with those bell notifications on. You don't want to miss when we upload a video like the one that you're watching right now. Check us out on social media at SoCal Exploring Media on Instagram and at SoCal Exploring on Twitter. And guys, I just redesigned the logo that I have been using for the longest time, the SoCal Exploring logo. No, it's not the animation that we have, but it's a SoCal Exploring like text logo. I just redesigned it to make it more modern. So we have new merch out on the TeePublic merch site. It's out now with that new design on. I'm really happy with it. Kind of modernized it a little bit, and I hope that you guys enjoy it. So if you want to purchase a t-shirt or a sticker or anything like that with that design on it or any of our podcast designs on it, then make sure you click the TeePublic link down below in the description. But in today's video, I'm here to tell you guys all the juicy details about Knott's Taste of Merry Farm, another food tasting event that we kind of expected that would be coming. With the success of Taste of Calico, the success of Taste of Knott's, and the recent success of Taste of Falloween, this one was kind of a given. And you know me, I love my Halloween season, I'm obsessed with it, but personally, I think that Taste of Merry Farm will probably be my favorite out of all the food tasting events that Knott's has done in the recent couple months. And the reason for that is because Knott's really knows how to deck up the park for the Christmas season. I mean, during Knott's Merry Farm, just without like COVID regulations, it looks absolutely beautiful. The entertainment is wonderful, and it's just a good vibe being at the park during Christmas time. And now, since they have to solely focus on, you know, not having the rides open and not having the theme park fully operational, they're going to put as much dedication and hard work into decking up the park as beautiful as possible and bringing the best themed entertainment possible, also being safe at the same time to give guests the fun, chilly vibes of Christmas. Now, if you guys are new and you don't know what any of these tasting events are, basically due to the current state restrictions because of COVID-19, the theme parks cannot operate fully at all. So they've been doing these food tasting events, and now they're doing a holiday themed one with over 60 unique food and beverage options. Now this time the price of the Merry Farm general admission will be $40. That's $5 more than the last one, $5 or $10 more than the one after that, and $15 more than the first one, Taste of Calico. Which is fine, I get it. I'm sure that they're basically opening the whole entire park. The only place that they're not gonna have open is the entrance to Knott's Berry Tales, and then cut off right there where the bumper cars are at, because actually they're adding one of the food stands, and it's that pizza place right by the bumper cars, so guests are gonna be able to go in that area. However, I think they're still gonna leave the entrance to Berry Tales blocked off a little bit. But with the $40 general admission ticket, not only do you get free parking, and free parking is available to everybody, but you get a tasting card. This tasting card is good for up to 5 tastings of any food and beverage options that Knott's Merry Farm has to offer during the event. And let me tell you guys, 5 tastings is plenty, especially on what you get. You know, it depends on if you choose just all the small offerings or if you choose just the dessert offerings, but I like to mix it up, a good mix of sweet and savory, and that's why I think that it's worth it to myself, because you know, I have a good small little entree, and then I have a bunch of other sweet stuff, but it fills my stomach up and I'm happy with the value that I got with experiencing these food tasting events and also getting to taste some of the delicious offerings that they have. Now, from the pictures that they sent out a picture of Santa, like he's gonna be meeting and greeting. Now, I don't think you'll have the traditional Santa meet and greet that we usually see at Knott's Berry Farm, but I'm sure we'll have some type of socially distanced meet and greet, or maybe even something virtual. Who knows? I think it'll be really cool. I think it'd be cool if they can pull something off similar to like Turtle Talk with Crush over at the Disneyland Resort, where you have Santa on a screen and kids can go up and take their turns talking to him, or take the microphone and talk to him, and then Santa can still interact with the kids. I think that'd be very, very smart, and I think that kids and families, like parents and stuff, would be very happy with that, especially since they'd feel safe. And that thought literally just came out of nowhere. That idea came out of nowhere as I'm filming this video. I did not think about that at all before. But let's get into some of the food offerings that they have. Now, this isn't the full menu that I'm going to read off to you guys, but these are a couple of food options that you will be able to taste at Taste of Merry Farm. Scrooge's spicy cranberry pomegranate glazed wings, pulled pork mac and cheese, chocolate peppermint cheesecake bars, Blitzen's Christmas tree bundt cake, North Pole oatmeal toffee cookie witch, Rudolph's winter pear lemonade, and the red concha stuffed with ice cream, which I am extremely excited about. Now, the event kicks off on Friday, November 20th, and runs until January 3rd. But if Knott's follows the same track record that it has with the other tasting events, these events sell out extremely fast. So I'm highly encouraging you guys to go down to the link down below in the description, Knott's website, and purchase your tickets right now if you want to go to this event, because I'm telling you, they will sell out within weeks. But yeah, those are just a few of the food offerings and beverage offerings that Knott's will have to offer. You'll have to go to the event yourselves to check out all the offerings that they have. I'm excited. I feel like I'm gonna like the food the most at this event. I'm pretty sure I said that with Taste of Following too, but the more and more food that they release and more they announce stuff, I'm like, wow, I'm more excited for that. And that just goes to show you that Knott's is doing a fabulous job at keeping it fresh. They really are doing a great job at giving people something to enjoy while still being COVID safe, since they can't open up their theme park for full operations. So as always, big shout out to Knott's Fairy Farm. You guys are killing it. And of course, I'll be out there. I don't know if I'll be out there on opening day or if I'll be out there on opening week. It just all depends on my schedule and how I feel, like, comfort wise, because at night it does get kind of packed and busy. However, for you guys, I'm gonna go a little bit later in the evening whenever I do decide to go to, you know, film all the pretty Christmas lights all lit up at night and everything, because for Taste of Halloween, everybody was saying how beautiful it looked at night. So I really want to see how Taste of Merry Farm looks at night, all pretty and lit up. But that does it for today's video. So I want to know down below in the comments section which food item you're most excited for and why. Let me know down in the comments section down below. My name is Scott, and you've been watching SoCal Exploring. Positivity is key, and most importantly, remember to keep exploring. Peace out, everybody.